Normally, if I go to a place for the first time, I go to other places also. So I went to Pachar, and I saw a lot of children in the village. A lot of children, over 200 children, were not going to school. And I asked what was the problem. They said, well, there was a time, they are small ones, they are traveling from Pachar to Funabantan. Three of them had an accident now. They all died. That's very true. Two are from the same period. And the other one is shared a compound, but that's not the same period. And I said, so that's the reason why you are going to send your children. They said, yes. I said, well, what are they going to do now? They said, well, we have preferred them to go on to the Madras education. The reading the Quran. And I said, yes, very good. I said, I also read the Quran, because I can read it. I know not all the children are going to be imams. They said, yes. I said, well, why do you have to keep them at home? Let them know something that I have to worship God better. And they said, yes. I said, is it possible to take them to school? They said, no. I said, well, I have two options. We can provide a donkey cart or donkey cart that can transport the children from Pachar to Funabantan. Or we start a school here. They said, no, that one will not happen. You cannot start a school here. Because we have been trying over the years, we failed. I said, no, what happened? They said they wrote a letter to the ministry, they wrote a letter to the directorate, the National Assembly member was consulted, but no avail. I said, okay, give me a chance. They probably have a different question. I said, well, first what I will do is, I will take a census of the children. So I went to compound to compound to write names of all the children who are not going to school. Sometimes I would do that, because like if I go there in the evening after school, I would find most of the parents in the house, because then they were in the field, in the right field. So I would wait until after Maghrib prayer, for 10 o'clock. When they come back, we start introducing all the things. So we'll be there for several of myself, Raphael, and some of my teachers, and there's one something to read there. He was very good. He really assisted. And Nyumi Baba was also very helpful. Because some compounds, if you go there, they will not welcome me.
Because of your mission.
Yes. So I told them there was a particular compound where I was about to go to. And I said I'll go there. That one is that's where the school is, the Arabic school. The big dad.
Okay.
They said I should not go there. I said I will go there. This man will not kill me. I'll go there. So, you see, when I went there and I had small discussions with the man, and I told him what my mission was, he was very happy.
Okay.
He shook hands with me and said his brothers who are in America advised him to send his children to school. But he did not send them because he's afraid that, you know, when they travel to Funabantan, like what has happened to the children.
So this
is why, you know, instead he did not send them. And I said, okay, my intention is to start a small school here. Until when the children get older and they can take care of themselves, that they can move to Funabantan. I said, it may also be that when children can continue up to grade 6, then from there they can also transit to St. Teresa. All these things are possible. I said, my intention is we don't want to find any child outside the school playing or doing anything. I said, that is too bad for you and too bad for the country. And he said, no problem, that's my children's name. He called them, Lamin, come out. Ah, come out. So I was writing their names and they were giving their place of blood. This was how I got everything. So I wrote a letter to the ministry to appeal my approval. And when they saw it, they were also very happy. So they came, we had a meeting there, and they knew that what I was saying was true. One of the directors also told me, he was also passing through Brikamaba, and he saw many children. And he was wondering what happened to his children. He said, so if I come up with such an initiative, I think it's what combination. So he told me, why are you on that? This is how everything started. So I asked the parents whether they have a place where we can start. They said yes, they had an old room where we started. So yes. Very old.
Very old.
So all we did was we just take a broom and we swept the walls. Of course the doors were not fixed, we pushed the doors and we started there. And I gave them a stand plan from my school, gave them some textbooks, that's how we started. And I sent my teachers there. So they were there for 1 year. Then the following year, the community, I told them that they have to identify a place. And they took me to that end. I also invited the ministry. We went there, they saw the place, they said, yes, this is ideal. So we told them to start something on their own, to show that they are really committed to education. And they started erecting that temporal house. So they had some troubles with some colleagues. So I had to appeal to the guys and say, please help us so that we'll be able to live. And John definitely came to our aid. Supported us, gave us some colleagues, which I gave to the community to one by, so that told them I'm empowering, so take this money. I showed them the text message I read from John, and I told them the amount, and I said, here is the money. Mm-hmm. But I'm not going to move an inch, go and buy and come and
find
me here.
Yeah, okay, yeah.
So they sent somebody to the Kamba. He bought these things and brought and found me sitting down, and I took out the receipt, and I said, good, now these items I know you're going to sell them. And I told them, tomorrow morning, I'll come and see whether you have sold it. So the following morning, I went there, I found them on it. In the evening, I went back. I said, tomorrow I want to finish. The third day, they finished everything. I said, fine, good. So now I have something that I can present. That when I took the photographs, and I sent them to these guys. And I said, thank you so much. People are thanking you, and everybody started. This is how everything started. And now, the school is really growing very fast.
Yeah, definitely. Well, we're putting power in the structure now.
Good.
Really,
Fajar.
Okay, never you are the one who started the initiative.
I was the one who started.